Whoever does well today will be the engine of the month. I am surely going to be the engine of the month tomorrow. There's no point in you three competing.
I'm sure we'll have a good chance.
I don't think so.
I think I've got the best chance.
You're not gonna take Mr. Mortar away from me.
No!
It's Christmas time on the island of Sodor. It's very cold, but the engines don't mind. They love this time of the year, when the stations all look jolly in their decorations. And there's plenty of work, with passengers and parcels to be delivered, no matter what the weather. It was only a few days until Christmas, but James was in a boastful mood. Ever since he'd been announced engine of the month back in June, after the incident with Sasha, Dudley and Yeardley, which caused a controversy, James had been announced a few days afterwards, and he wouldn't stop boasting about it. I bet I will be an engine of the month this Christmas again. You never know, they might have an accident again and I'll be announced a few days after. I'm just a lucky engine.
Oh, shut up, James, grumbled Thomas. You've been going on about it for a long time now. Why can't you just keep your mouth shut?
Because I'm a splendid red engine, not a silly engine like you guys.
Then the fat controller arrived on Duck. He had a special announcement to make.
There is to be a festival of Christmas lights, he announced. And there is also a competition to find the best Christmas lights display. And a trophy will be rewarded to the winner. I want you all to help with the preparations.
And he left. The engines were excited. That means the stations will be decorated with Christmas lights and enter the competition too.
I bet Farquhar Station will have a good chance, said Thomas.
Oh, I don't know, said Emily. I think Mayfreight might have a good bet.
James snorted. Why the stations? We can enter ourselves. All we need to do is get our own Christmas lights and decorate Tip of Sheds. Then we might have a chance to win the competition.
That will be a great idea, puffed Gordon.
Indeed, agreed Henry.
Just then, Bill and Ben puffed up. They have come to pick up some trucks to take back to the quarry.
Oh, something must be happening. That's right, Bill, replied Ben. What's going on?
There's going to be a competition to find the best Christmas lights display on Sodor, explained Thomas.
Bill and Ben were excited. Then they had a thought.
Maybe we should enter ourselves, Ben.
Maybe we should, Bill.
We might decorate our own quarry hoppers,
tooted Ben.
Pah, snorted James. Quarry hoppers are really dirty and dusty. There's no way they'll look grand with Christmas lights.
That made Bill and Ben very cross. They didn't like being told that their quarry was too dusty.
It is true, but they are very proud of their work.
Just you wait and see, James. Our quarry is going to look better than your sheds. You'll see.
Graham overheard the whole conversation, and he knew that he and James hated each other. He wanted to help the twins. Later that morning, Graham was sent to help Bill and Ben at the quarry. Mavis had to go to the diesel works to have her engine checked in case it needs to be repaired or replaced before the new year comes. After Mavis left,
Graham spoke to the twins. I heard about what was going on this morning while I was at Titmouth Yard. The twins were surprised. Why don't we all team up together and decorate the whole Quarry with Christmas lights?
But we haven't got many Christmas lights,
tooted Bill.
Yes, replied Ben. Because the only lights we got were ones when we moved in with Mavis back in 2001, and they didn't work then.
I've seen a truck full of Christmas lights, said Graham. Let's go and get them. If we're going to beat the big engines at Titmouth, we'll need loads of new lights. And the three engines set off to collect some lights. When Graham and the twins arrived at Titmouth Yard, Titmouth sheds were already decorated with lots of Christmas lights.
Oh, checking out our lights, guys, boasted James.
Pah! There's nothing to check, snorted Bill.
Oh, we'll see about that, snorted Gordon. Peter, can you switch on the lights, please?
Righto, Peter called.
And then the Christmas lights switched on.
Wow! They look magnificent,
tooted Henry excitedly. Bill and Ben gasped in amazement. Then, as Peter walked up, Graham spoke to him.
What's going to happen to the rest of those Christmas lights in those vans, Peter? He asked.
Oh, they're needed for Natford Town, replied Peter.
They're for the competition entries.
Shall we deliver them for you?
Aren't you busy at the quarry already?
Oh no, we can do them easily. We have to pick up some trucks over there anyway.
But Peter didn't know the fame of Graham's plan to beat the big engines. When Graham and the twins got back to the quarry with the Christmas lights, the hopper was soon decorated with them. But they didn't know that James had been spying on them until Bill and Ben spotted them.
Can someone switch on the lights? Tooted Bill.
So the workmen switched on the Christmas lights. They looked beautiful.
Wow! Henry was right! They look magnificent! Tooted Ben.
Exactly, Bill! They look marvellous!
Ha! Beat that, James! Gloated Graham.
Yes!
Tooted the twins.
Our Quarry is going to easily win the competition!
That made James very cross.
Well, we're going to be putting more lights to the sheds, and they're way better than yours. Much better than you've ever seen.
He huffed and he raced away.
But we need to get some more too. He's surely going to outdo us.
Tooted Ben.
Don't worry, tooted Graham. We got loads of Christmas lights back in the van. They've got plenty as well. So we don't need to get any more. We've got plenty. All we need to do is decorate the areas of the quarry.
So the engines decorated the quarry instead of doing their jobs. And later that evening, the Christmas lights were ready. The workmen had put them into the special socket, but no one had noticed that they were all in one socket, and there were far too many lights. But Graham didn't notice either. He was feeling very pleased with himself and Bill and Ben.
This will surely beat the big engines once and for all, and it will stop James's boasting.
You can say that again, Graham. You get it, Bill?
Yes, Ben.
Okay, Ben. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Soon, all of the engines switched on the lights at both locations. They looked brighter than before.
Then there was trouble.
What happened? Gasped Bill.
The lights have gone out.
Oh no. I hope we didn't do anything.
I hope not too. What do you think, Ben?
Ben? Where are you?
Tooted Bill. But Ben didn't answer. And there was no sign of him.
Don't worry, Bill. I'm sure he might have got startled by the flash of the lights.
Why don't we all go and look for him?
so Graham and Bill puffed off to find Ben. But they can only go as far as the first set of sidings outside the quarry, because it is too dark, especially when they have their lamps on. An hour later, the lights came back on. They looked beautiful again, but Ben wasn't happy. He had been startled by the fuse box, which caused the whole blackout, and now he was stuck inside the snowy shed at the quarry. The lights didn't even make him feel any better.
I'm never gonna get out of here, he groaned. This is the worst Christmas ever.
Just then Mavis purred up.
Oh, Ben, what happened?
Oh, Mavis, we were trying to win the Christmas lights competition, but I'm stuck in this snowy tunnel.
Didn't Graham or Bill help you?
No. They went off looking for me. They couldn't see me because it was too dark.
I think it must be because of a power cut. The lights were off back at the diesel works,
purred Mavis.
Don't worry, Ben. I'll get you out of there.
A few minutes later, Graham and Bill puffed into Titmouth Yard. They still got their Christmas lights on, but it looked the same as they had earlier.
I thought you had loads of Christmas lights,
tooted Bill sadly. Well, we were, but after that blackout, our drivers took off some of them because there were way too many and they were all into one socket. He said it could cause a fire hazard.
Oh dear, Graham puffed sadly.
So none of you seen Ben then?
No, he hasn't even come by here.
Why?
Henry asked.
Because Ben has gone missing after the lights went out. I think something must have scared him. Oh, I know something must have happened to him, and it's going to be a lonely Christmas without him.
Bill felt miserable. He started to miss Ben. The big engines all felt sorry for him. Although at first, they were happy that Bill and Ben were apart, mainly because it means they won't be troublesome for quite some time. But Graham felt worst of all. He had wanted to help win the Christmas lights competition and he had spoiled everything. Graham felt terrible, and so did James, because he was the one who started it all by boasting in the first place. Just then, there were two engines coming. It was Mavis and Ben.
Bill! Ben! You're safe!
Tooted Bill happily.
Yes, indeed he is, boomed a voice. And what has been going on here?
Please, sir, Graham tooted. It was all my fault.
And he explained about the lights.
I'm sorry if I caused a power cut.
The fat controller still looked firm, but he smiled a little bit.
The power cut wasn't your fault, Graham. It just the fuse went out at all the stations. But there is one fault that you all caused.
What's that?
Asked James.
Well, you took all of the Christmas lights that meant to be delivered to Knapford Town. The entries were going to use them to decorate the town so they can enter the competition themselves. You've all been very greedy. Christmas was meant to be a time of giving presents.
So you're saying that the same goes for Christmas lights?
Yes, exactly my point, James.
But by the way, you're all teaming up against each other to win this. I'm afraid I have no option but to cancel the competition. The other contenders haven't got their lights. And it's too late. It's nearly time for the camel concert. The engines all felt bad. But then, Graham had an idea.
But excuse me, sir. Don't cancel it yet.
What I've already done. There are not many contenders anyway.
Well, forget about the competition, but why don't we show the passengers the Christmas lights we have decorated from the sheds and the quarry, and we can have the camel concert at the end?
Graham, I think that would be a fine idea. And all the engines agreed. So Graham collected the passengers from the station and took them to Titmouth Sheds for their first stop. They all thought it looked beautiful. It wasn't every day that the engine sheds were decorated with Christmas lights.
Well, except a few weeks ago. They all signed camels before setting off to the quarry in Bill and Ben's brake van special. And they thought the Christmas lights at the quarry looked marvellous and beautiful as well. Now, let the last song begin, boomed the Fat Controller, and the carolers began to sing the last Christmas carol song of the night. I'm sorry for being such a boastful moron lately. I hope you can all forgive me. Of course, James, tooted Graham. But you've got to admit, these lights here look a lot better than the ones at your shed. What do you mean, snorted James. Come on, admit it, tooted Graham. They look even better than your shiny red paint any day. That made James very cross. Why, when I get my buffers on you, Graham? You have to catch me first, tooted Graham, and he raced away. Something just never changed about those two. No, you're right there, Bill, tooted Ben. Then the twins had a thought. Sir, if you've cancelled the competition, what are you going to do with a trophy? Asked Bill. Well, there is one engine that should get a trophy for what they have done today. And the winner is Mavis, for being the best guide diesel on the whole of Sodor. And I think we can all agree on that. The twins agreed.
Oh, thank you, sir. I never won a trophy in all my life.
Well, I think it's about time you deserve your chance. Bill and Ben were very pleased for Mavis.
Getting a trophy is much better than being an Engine of the Month award any day.
And even Mavis had to agree. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Yeah. so tear.